HTC U11 Plus could have been the Pixel 2 XL if Google hadn't chosen LG to make the device. And indeed, the two phones have a lot in common: a 6 inches wide screen, similar design, Snapdragon 835 chip, a high-end 12MP camera with big pixels and HDR boost, rear-mounted fingerprint scanner, edge squeeze sensors, Android Oreo. But HTC has built on those features with its own boom speakers, richer squeeze functionality, wider aperture for the camera and 3D audio capturing for the vids, a bigger battery, and jaw-dropping design, especially in its translucent version. The 6GB RAM and microSD slot are welcome improvements, but we are yet to see if the Super LCD 6 screen has what it takes to meet the flagship needs. The 100% DCI-P3 color space coverage and HDR10 compliance should help its case, that's without a question. The audio jack is gone for good, at least as far as HTC is concerned, and that's plenty clear if you look at their recent phones. The U11 Plus is yet another smartphone to drop it from the specs list, but at least it got a watertight IP68 body to show for it. HTC U11 Plus will come bundled with a quick charge 3.0 compatible plug, a USB Type-C cable, and the HTC's U-Sonic noise cancelling in-ear headphones. The retail box will also contain a USB-C to 3.5mm adapter, a cleaning cloth, and a clear plastic case for extra protection. Unfortunately, we didn't get the HTC U11 Plus box in our office. But the HTC U11 we had for review a few months ago featured the same bundle, so you can satisfy your curiosity with its pictures instead. The HTC U11 Plus measures 158.5 by 74.9 by 8.5 millimeters, about the same as the Pixel 2 XL, but a hair thicker. The U11 Plus is 13 grams heavier than Pixel though, but still reasonable at 188 grams. Retiring the metal jackets in favor of glass is now officially a thing, but HTC's liquid surface shape dates back to the U Ultra and U Play January premiere. HTC was definitely onto something with that curved back design and ever-changing color, and it certainly gives the U11 Plus some character. On the opposite side, the HTC U11 Plus front is both as flagship and generic as it gets. The U11 Plus utilizes a 6 inches higher Super LCD 6, the latest available of this gap-free screens. It's one of those 18:9 wide screens, with super thin bezels, shaping as the next big thing on the market. There is a Gorilla Glass 5 to shield it, and that's pretty much it. No keys, no fingerprint scanner. The HTC U11 Plus has the newest 6th generation gap-free LCD screen known as Super LCD 6. It's a 6 inches QHD unit with 538 pp density. The underlying matrix is of the regular RGB kind. The HTC U11 Plus comes with a sealed 3930 mAh battery, enough for a phablet of its caliber. It supports Quick Charge 3.0, and the phone is bundled with a compatible charger that fills 35% of a depleted battery in half an hour. The HTC U11 Plus's Snapdragon 835 enables a vast variety of connectivity options thanks to the chipset's modem. Single SIM variants will be capable of LTE Cat 16 with theoretical speeds of 1024/150 Mbps. Meanwhile, the dual SIM models will be Cat 15 with theoretical speeds of 800/150 Mbps. All variants support Wi-Fi 802.11b/g/n for 2.4 GHz and 802.11a/nac for 5 GHz, dual band Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi Direct, Bluetooth 5.0, AGPS, and GLONASS are also present. The USB-C port may be used for OTG and is capable of USB 3.1 speeds. There's also support for Qualcomm's Quick Charge 3.0. NFC is also here, of course. The HTC U11 Plus runs on Android Oreo with Sense UI on top of it. since has gotten leaner over the years, with the most drastic reduction happening last year when HTC decided that it would let Google take care of the core apps by shutting down HTC's in-house apps like Browser, Calendar, and Gallery, among others. Let's get right into it. Starting off, ways to wake the device, there are several enabled by default. You can press the power key, double tap the screen, tap the fingerprint sensor, or slide up on the screen to unlock from sleep. The lock screen offers you four app shortcuts, which are identical to the ones you have on your home screen. HTC calls its new squeeze feature EdgeSense. The sides of the phone are embedded with pressure sensors. This allows you to have two gestures to program to whatever app you'd like. One that may be particularly useful is the camera app, though. You can achieve the same result by double pressing the power key and using the volume rocker to toggle. The HTC U11 Plus is powered by the Qualcomm's current flagship chip, the Snapdragon 835, 8X Cryo CPU, Adreno 540 GPU. This means HTC has done everything it can do to ensure the U11 Plus is powerful, and we don't expect any surprises. The mainstream version of the U11 Plus has 6GB RAM and 128GB storage, though there is a limited model with 4GB RAM and 64GB storage available in some markets. Sense UI includes a straightforward dialer. There are 5 tabs: call history, phone, favorites, people, and groups. The cool thing about this dialer is you can switch between a number pad and a full keyboard. HTC has retired its app suite, and now it's up to Google's default apps for handling everything. Those are more than capable, of course. You get photos for pictures and videos, Play Music for your audio files, YouTube for online streaming, and Chrome for web browsing. HTC first introduced its USONIC headphones on the HTC 10 Evo, aka Bolt, which was coincidentally the first HTC device without a headphone jack. With the U11 Plus, HTC is debuting a new feature to its USONIC earbuds, active noise cancellation. The included earbuds can actively cancel background noise thanks to all the processing of extraneous noise taking place on the phone rather than in the earbuds. Unfortunately, our review unit did not come bundled with a USB-C to 3.5mm adapter. This means we couldn't test the audio quality, because it very much depends on what kind of headphones or adapter you have. Each has its own DAC and has to be tested individually. The good news is that the HTC U11 Plus comes with a pair of USONIC headphones, so you are ready to go out of the box. They are in-ear headphones, though, if you want on or over-ear, you have to provide your own. The HTC U11 Plus has a 12MP UltraPixel 3OIS camera with an f/1.7 aperture, 1.4 micrometers pixels, ultra speed, read dual pixel, autofocus, and a dual LED flash. The camera makes use of image stacking and supports the so-called HDR boost, where it fully utilizes that image stacking. The camera app interface is quite simple. Everything is organized into a drawer of modes and settings on the left. If it doesn't make sense at first, imagine that this drawer is the hamburger menu of any other app. HTC U11 Plus can take 4K videos at 30fps and 1080p clips with either 30 or 60fps. There is a 5-minute cap for the 4K vids, which might be inconvenient for some. Thanks to the 4MX on the HTC U11 Plus, its camcorder can capture either 3D audio with acoustic zoom or high-res audio. The 3D audio uses AAC codec, 96kbps, and is the default option. The videos come in MP4 containers, and in spite of the low bitrate, the sound is impressive. Once meant to be a part of Google's lineup, the U11 Plus has now become HTC's flagship for the holiday season instead. Competing with the Pixel 2 XL won't be easy, but HTC has tried to make the U11 Plus special, attractive, and competitive. What could go wrong, right? Well, one thing stands out. The U11 Plus fails in what many would consider the most important foundation of a good smartphone: the screen. Sure, the 6-inch LCD has a flagship grade resolution, contrast, and wide gamma color support. But HTC has used a panel with low max brightness and we noticed color and contrast shifting when looking at an angle. Then there is the battery life. Unlike what the beefy battery capacity may suggest at first look, the U11 Plus's battery life is in fact average at best. That was especially true for on-screen tests, which probably means the screen panel is again to blame. Thank you.